Boom, hey internets, brand new episode of Brand Hype. You know I had to feature Johnny Cupcakes. Not only the brand, but the brilliant man behind him. That's coming up next. Run it. Okay, we're talking Johnny Cupcakes. If you are subscribed to the channel, it's no surprise that I talk about Johnny Cupcakes all the time. I think from the emergence of my channel way early on, I was watching Johnny Cupcakes moves and how he maneuvered through a lot of the changes that happened, because as I'm shooting this, right, 20 years working in the apparel industry, I still think he's an anomaly in a lot of different ways. If we pull up on the website at the time that I'm shooting this, the quote is, "World's first t-shirt bakery." And if you're just reading that and have no idea who Johnny Cupcakes is or understand the vision and how deep the company is, it just makes you think. It makes you read on and say, what is this all about? And that in a lot of ways kind of encompasses, it's like that dot, dot, dot. Well, let me inspect more. Let me figure out what this is about. And a lot of ways, that discovery of Johnny Cupcakes, I think, is unique to a person who is a fan of Johnny Cupcakes. So let's bring it back a little bit. His background is something I know a lot about just because I followed a lot of his moves. But early on, a part of music and a band, and realized that they needed to have merch. And so he got into making t-shirts and making the designs at a very early age, and then realized he kind of fell in love with it. And so there's a lot of things that happened from then and now in terms of really avant-garde moves to create the movement that is Johnny Cupcakes. And I really think it's a movement. It's actually past a lifestyle. A lot of people will put lifestyle in the description of their brand, even if they just made it 10 minutes ago. But really, I think what he's created is really cultivated a culture of raving fans that are part of a family that then support what is Johnny Cupcakes and all of his endeavors. And I think the brilliant part of how he maintains it is how he communicates with that base very well. So early on, one of the first big moves that he made is he actually went on tour peddling the shirts. So he did multiple tours in the very beginning of the brand. And so he would go city to city and sell the shirts. It's the equivalent of a band playing shows, whether they're small town shows or mid-size arenas. He would just go on tour and sell the shirts. And as that continued to grow, he kind of revisited it later. And he would do the Johnny Cupcakes tour, and he would pop up, he'd do a pop-up shop in very different locations. So he would do it at an actual bakery or just places that would be unexpected. And it's, again, it's a theme that goes on where he'll do something kind of weird and embrace that, or something just really different and avant-garde, like away from what you might think is cool or status quo. He goes with what is more interesting, I would say, is a good way to describe how he moves on a lot of his gut feelings in terms of the business. And so that idea of going person to person, meeting the people who are actually buying the product, I think was a good basis for him starting a big fanfare of the company. And so if you pull up to one of the locations that he has, the first one being in Boston, and he has several locations of flagships around the world, it's curated like a bakery. So many times people pull up thinking they're gonna buy something sweet, and it's all t-shirts and accessories and garments, it's clothing. And so people actually get pissed off about it. It's kind of funny. And it's a very interesting point, because people will actually argue with him and say, why don't you actually sell cupcakes? You would make so much money. But even the hate that he gets from people who have no idea that's a huge worldwide clothing line is kind of noteworthy and funny. You know, it creates something else to talk about, and it creates a larger conversation, which is one reason. I mean, logistically too, running a food business is completely different than having a clothing business, but have it encapsulated in the theme just gives it so many more angles to love about the clothing line. So if we pull up to the website and hit shop, you're gonna see a whole range of products. The experience on the site is great, super seamless. Very little clicks to get through to purchase. You can see a good range of product. I really like that you can choose the tabs at the top of the page so you can get the product you want to look at and actually shop for. He has a lot of categories. A lot of it revolves around soft goods, so anything that's printables. But the bigger thing that I want to highlight is he has an entire speaking career. He's done TED Talks, he's done a lot. He's been featured on a lot of shows. And so he has an entire career speaking. And in these talks, he'll really break down his ideology and thought process through navigating his business. And it's super valuable, especially if you're subscribed to this channel here. I highly suggest you follow him and subscribe to his YouTube channel to see the type of things he speaks about. Also, one of the tabs is Cake Dealers, and I did a video on this, so I'll put a link to it up here or in the descriptions, where I think it's a brilliant way for him to continue in that idea of dealing with the mass public through people. So people to people is always his business, is always a way of marketing and reaching out and spreading the word of his products. Maybe more so than the clothing is that idea of how he has such a really strong bond with the people who have fandom for his brand. One of the very first things that I realized he did, which I thought was brilliant early on, is he would do these events. He did Dee Dee Reese in Westwood, out by UCLA. And he did an event there where they just kind of popped up and they said, hey, if you show up in the next several hours wearing something Johnny Cupcakes, I have a free ice cream sandwich for you. And this is what Dee Dee Reese is famous for. So he basically bought out the shop for several hours. But really what he's giving them, besides a free ice cream sandwich, is an experience. I mean, it's a chance to meet Johnny Cupcakes, the founder of the company. And this is what I'm talking about, where he works through people to spread the word of his brand. A lot of people use social media to communicate at scale. He'll use it to come back and talk to the individual. He has a slew of different events where he'll think of where there could be an experience had by the people who patron his brand. And it's super brilliant. It's super smart marketing spend. It's just a great way to approach spreading the word about your business, and especially something in fashion where it's super competitive. So there you go. All of the links of all the aforementioned will be in the descriptions. If you guys have anything to talk about, any comment, if you're a Johnny Cupcakes fan, go ahead and drop some comments about your experience with the Johnny Cupcakes brand and maybe why you love it. But any of my other questions about anything that you guys want to drop, like if you like, sub if you love, and ring the bell. Follow me on social media when you get a chance. I will see you guys on the next one. Bye.